Which kids? That's what we're here.
I don't know. Are we live?
Hey, everybody. Good evening.
It's working.
Yes, we're good. We're good. All right. I think I'm looking over here. Sorry. It's another Monday night, but we've been off for a couple weeks, so
froze to death.
I know. Last week at this time, it was like 8 degrees, right? It was
Monday. That
was that crazy day. Yeah, we all were out without power and stuff off and on last week, but we are good. We've all got power and water, and
we were so fortunate.
All the things we take for granted.
Good.
Not
gracious.
Anymore, though.
Well, we hope y'all are doing well. Tell us where you are tonight.
Yes.
Where are you watching from? And we have had a busy afternoon.
We have.
We've been practicing, not for tonight, but other things coming up.
Tonight's, we would never practice for this show.
Tonight's fly by the seat of our pants. You know how that
As
goes.
Usual. That's when we have the most fun, though.
Yeah. Well, we're going to start out with a great old song, Since Jesus Came Into My Heart and He Keeps Me Singing.
Arranged by David Clydesdale. We probably should have practiced this one. Right?
Here we go.
All right, am I at the top?
You're at the top.
Oh. Recognize both of those, right? Since Jesus came into my heart and He keeps me singing. Both songs I grew up singing in church. I'm sure many of y'all did as well.
It's always great to start out with something upbeat.
That's right. Get the blood pumping and the toes tapping. Well, we've got all sorts of fun hymns and songs just like those that we all grew up singing. That we want to play for you tonight. And you can leave a request in the comments. If we see one pop up, we might just play it.
Leave us a comment, and you know, they move quick, but we'll try.
That's right.
it's so divine. Fantastic, y'all.
When we play it that slow, I lose track of what beat we're on. I'm like, did we already?
I always think we're on three and we're on two.
I love slow tempos, though. It just gives you time to sit in it, you know, and really enjoy it. But the fast is fun, too. We like to mix it up. All right. Well, what else?
Well, right after this little list here we've got...
I don't know if mine are in the same order.
Just
as yours,
a little talk with Jesus.
Oh, yeah, mine are in a different order. Let me find it here.
Oh, we'll have to get that straightened out.
Oh, let us.
Now.
There it is.
Y'all know that we like to start this one slow, and then we'll be off to the races. Here we go.
Was it
thank you.
Don't y'all love that one?
I had the opportunity. I've already played, other than our stuff this afternoon, I did a whole thing this morning for about over an hour.
But
many of y'all will remember T. Bob Davis, Dr. T. Bob Davis from Dallas, fabulous pianist. We got together this morning over at Dr. Ginter's, and we started our Monday with hymns, and it was fantastic. But I can tell that it's been a long day.
Yeah, I know, right?
Dr. Ginter called and said, can you be here at 9 in the morning? And I thought, well, I haven't played with that force at 9 in a long time. But, hey, we made it work.
It's not like you were working yesterday.
We had the yes, and yesterday we had church and Gerald Wolf and Greater Vision. And Saturday night we did a concert.
Wow.
It's really been wide open, y'all, and we're so blessed.
Of course. After a year of almost nothing, you know, it's nice to have.
It's so such a blessing. Why don't we do Because He Lives?
Oh, I love it. I was just
we've got at least one alto singing. I saw a comment.
Alto, you said?
An alto in the choir.
I bet we could cover all the parts with everyone watching.
We're going to have all the parts one day. We're going to get together. I'm serious.
I see lots of altos. Listen, now. Everyone's singing alto.
Well, if we have any high sopranos, y'all will be on my team. Okay, look, when this is over, though, we're going to find a big central location and have a weekend convention.
We must.
So that we can all sing together and
sing these hymns.
Have all these people together. It'll be fantastic. Listen, tomorrow, y'all, we're going to be on the Mark Lowry Show. Woo! Do y'all know Mark Lowry?
Can't
He's
wait.
Okay.
I think they might be familiar.
If you don't know Mark Lowry, you need to, and we'll be on his show. Well, if all technical things. So we have some, he doesn't have two pianos at his house, but we want to do a little teaser for the concert. So yes, we're going to try to wire in over here to his house and be on his show. So don't miss it. Tomorrow, 11 Central, Mark Lowry, Facebook, all of his platforms.
Absolutely. We're so excited about our concert coming up with him on March 7th at Chapelwood. And of course, that'll be broadcast and everything, I think, on his page as well.
It'll
right?
be on yeah. our pages and Mark's page and Chapelwood. And
We're so you know, excited and honored and grateful that he would be able to join us and be with us in concert. So we know y'all won't want to miss that. There's a high soprano. Virginia says she's a high soprano.
Tomorrow at 11, people are asking what time.
Yes.
Tomorrow. So, and yes, it doesn't matter what voice part you sing. If you make a joyful noise to the Lord, that's what he calls us to do. He doesn't tell us how. Well, he does talk about that we'll use stringed instruments and pipes and all that, the flute and the lyre and all that. But as long as you're making a joyful noise, that's all he cares about, because that's what we're doing.
I've never played a lyre before, but if someone has one, send it to me. I'll learn how to play the lyre.
I want to take up theremin.
I love the theremin. about this one.
Somebody said something about the 90 and 9 on here.
Yes.
We talked about that song, and I was looking, one of my favorite composers, I don't know if she's watching tonight, but her name is Erlene Rientz, and
oh, yes.
I was on her website this week looking at some music that I want to get for the choir, and she has an arrangement of
Did
the 90 and 9.
That's so funny.
And I was reminded that we hadn't done it, so... We're going to have
to find
it.
I'm
going
to have to find music because it's one of those I grew
People
up seeing.
People have been asking us for it.
I even remember, I think we did like a church play or something about Ira Sankey, who wrote that,
okay.
90 and 9. But I don't remember all the words, so I'll have to look it up.
Well, I saw that last night. I was actually looking.
I just remember it ends with, and I was that one lost sheep. That's how it ends.
I'm going to have to learn it. All right. Well, you all are blessings to us, and so I want to make many more blessings out of what we're doing. So we're going to do Make Me a Blessing. Ooh. Oh, there's Erlene. She is watching.
Wonderful.
How cool is that? Yeah. We'll have to look up her arrangement.
Someone today.
How cool. So many good songs.
I know. We're just churning through them here.
And
hey, sorry.
Time is flying.
It is flying. I saw one jumped out. Oh, what about Praise Him?
Praise Him, Praise Him, Jesus, our blessed Redeemer.
Yeah.
Says the 90 and 9 is in the Broadman hymnal. Okay. I think my copy of The Brahmin is at Mama's. My grandmother gave it to me years ago.
I haven't seen that song in forever. The 99.
Yeah, someone made a comment about seeing our hands, and I want to say that in the spring we're going to start looking at some new camera. We got the sound equipment kind of upgraded, and so next is camera stuff. And
one step so at a time.
You might start. Yeah, I'm really excited about it.
Absolutely.
Start seeing them. Different angles. Similar.
Those are a little bit interchangeable.
Great day. Those are very similar. Well, we were doing this one before we started. Know we're having a great time. Somebody said, what now?
Paul said, you may be Methodist, but your fingers reveal your Baptist heritage.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I grew up Baptist. So, well, you grew up Methodist, though.
I surely did.
But some of that Baptist influence must have seeped in somehow. We can hear it. All right.
Laura said that sounded like Vestal.
Ooh, well, that's...
That's one of the first people on my list to meet when I get to heaven.
That is high praise.
I don't know how I'll find her home, her mansion, but I'm going to.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, Till the Storm Passes By.
Oh, yes.
Someone asked for that. We really need to do that.
Let's do it.
I don't know that we have an arrangement right off the bat, but...
I've got something.
Thank you. Let's sing this chorus.
Thank you.
there's a gentleman watching from back home, and he's Methodist, Vance, and he's right. The Methodists did play like this. Maybe on Sunday mornings it was heavy organ and stuff, you know, formal like we do at Chapelwood. But we would in the summer have something called camp meeting. And they would have the Cokesbury hymnal. And boy, did I ever learn runs and stuff on the piano at camp meeting and played for that all the time. So Methodist was pretty, our church was, you know, organ driven. But in the summertime, oh my, we did all kind of stuff.
Did y'all ever do Wonderful Grace of Jesus?
Oh, we always did Wonderful Grace of Jesus.
That was one of our favorites growing up. I mean, someone always requested Wonderful Grace of Jesus.
I want y'all to know that Miss Pearl is watching, and she's not Miss Pearl on here, and I don't know how to find her page. But she comes on at times and gives life-changing advice. Her take on things is... what we all should be listening to. So if y'all know her, she's watching, and she's about to get her hanky out. But it's so good to see you. And when I come to Georgia, I hope to see you at one of our concerts. So, you know, I was raised in Warner Robins, and they're in a different part of the state. But Georgia is so small. We all know the same people. And so much fun. Yes, Epworth by the Sea. They had all kind of things. Well, listen, several people have asked for you to do One Pair of Hands. We had not planned on doing it, but we have not done it in so long.
It has been a little while. I love doing it when Cam plays because he adds all the fancy stuff.
And so we'll do One Pair of Hands just for you all. And James does such a good job on this. And remind me, was it Elvis that sang this?
Several did, but yes, Elvis did sing this one.
Yeah. All right. Well, here we go. Okay. This is a ADD. That's part of Love is a Mini Splendor from Greece.
Love is a mini splendor.
Okay. I'm sorry.
I believe it.
I'll behave.
There's nothing new under the sun.
Thank you.
I love that song.
That one is always so much fun to play.
I love the way it just builds and builds, and such a great message. One pair of hands. Put your faith into one pair of hands.
How about?
When life goes wrong, like it does. What were you going
to
say?
Listen, I'd hate to take somebody else's words, but this weekend at the Greater Vision concert, Gerald was talking about people and how they have challenges and how do you find joy in the current situation. Don't focus on the things that are going wrong if you can help it, because there's so much going on that there's joy. And when God has made a decision that there's something that we don't like, there's not a whole lot we can do about it. And so we've all figured that out this past year and this week. You know, I think we all thought that 2021 was going to just
magically erase everything.
Yes. That's not the case.
It's been quite a year so far
a
already.
A ride, y'all. And so
just last week was enough, I think, for a lot of people.
How about this song? I must tell Jesus.
Makes me think of I'd rather have Jesus.
Sing it.
Than silver or gold. I'd rather be his than have riches untold. I'd rather have Jesus than houses or lands. I'd rather be led by his nail-pierced hands than to be
spirit, all with me.
Jesus, and we're gonna let him be that you be the King.
That's got to be one of my all-time favorite hymns.
Listen, I have a story about George Beverly Shea.
Oh, please.
I haven't been able to go see it yet, but at some point, George Beverly Shea's Steinway B came available for sale, and Dr. Ginter purchased it. And it's here in town at a location in a church on display. And
can y'all believe that?
He was playing it some in the mornings before their services, so... Hopefully one day, but while I'm talking about Dr. Ginter, I can't tell you how special, you know, the piano thing brought us together, but their genuine love for music and the Lord and what they are trying to do for so many people, and at their home, these garage concerts that they're starting are really something. I mean, I'm excited to death.
I've seen some videos. It looks like,
you know,
a blast.
We're going to go over there sometime and do one. But,
we must.
You know, we all need to be advocates for gospel music and for hymns. And I know that if you're watching this, you likely are. But if we're not advocates and sharing this music and doing everything we can to get it out, then it may not always be around. But I feel like there's a revival coming. After this COVID stuff, people are going to want to hear these good old songs, and we're already ready to go. So y'all sing these hymns every day.
Like this one. Play all night if
I hadn't started at 9 o'clock this morning. We have 12 minutes and we're gonna jam everything in that we can.
All right,
you got one coming up?
Yeah, well, I saw, what about Standing on the Promises? We haven't done that.
Ooh,
one.
We can pick it up with that.
Here we go. That's just a little talk. Thank you. about this one? Tempted and tried, we're oft made to wonder why it should be thus all the day long. Well, there are
seen hand to me that leads me through ways I cannot see. There's Henrietta from New Orleans, praise be. While going through this world of woe, this hand still leads me where I go. I'm holding to the unseen hand that guides me through.
His hand has left. shadows drear, and while it leads, I have no fear. I know 'twill that home where sin nor sorrow ever can come.
I'm holding to that still guides me through all this weary land, and some sweet day, oh, I'm gonna reach that strand.
Gorgeous. Y'all, these old hymns, you just don't hear them very much these days. I mean, that one, I don't remember the last time I've heard that one, but.
Well, I don't know how you could, I mean, the words where it talks about my favorite part, that guides me through the land and some sweet day I'm going to reach that strand. Mm. Can y'all imagine what the strand is going to look like? Lord. Well, listen, wow. It has been, we'll do one more song to close, but
Lord,
we don't take
time
for granted this opportunity to come on
Absolutely.
Here with this audience. And we love you. You know that. We say it week in and week out. And I don't want it to get old and complacent, because that's not it at all. We mean that deeply from our hearts. Don't forget to watch us on Mark Lowry tomorrow,
yes.
11 o'clock. Tune in to Mark Lowry on his show. We'll be talking about our upcoming concert together. We had a fun conversation today. We need your prayers. We got some big stuff coming up that are in the logistical works. We don't like the logistical stuff for the course.
That's right. Gotta
but we could use your
stuff.
Prayers with everything coming up. But I wanted to do Aunt Nina's favorite.
Perfect.
Where could I go but to the Lord?
Oh, yes.
We're going to close with that tonight. And it's always such a pleasure. Let us know. Yes, all the, you know, there's not going to be a lot of preaching in heaven. It's going to be all singing. So there's sermons within these hymns. Somebody asked me one day, why don't you give your testimony and you don't do a whole lot of scriptural-based speaking? And I said, well, truthfully. And
just listen to the words.
Yes. Truthfully, my gift is not in speaking. Mm. And if taking this talent that I have at the keyboard, that is my story. And that's the message that comes from the song. So we love y'all, and we will see you soon. We're going to close out with this song has been around for so long.
I know.
And let's see, you sing this, right?
I have sung this, yes.
Okay.
Living Below.
All right, y'all have a good week, and we'll see you soon.
Alone to face temptation sore.
with friends. We love you all of you, dear.
All of you.
Comfort I get from God's own word. Yet when I face the chilling hand of death,
for watching.
We'll see you tomorrow. I'm Mark Lowry.
Next time. Yes.
Love you.